Hello friends, now we will go for very simple topic matrices. You know what is the meaning of the matrices? What actually matrices stands for? I just say this is just like an almirah where the goods are kept. Just see here. It is just like this almirah I'm writing here. This is first row, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is first column. This is second row, this is second column. Suppose these are the goods of Monu, these are the goods of Sonu. This is the rack where books are kept, and this is the rack where clothes are kept. Okay, so if I just say, where the clothes of Monu kept, you will come Monu's column and row of clothes. So it is 4 here. If I say Sonu's book, you will come to Sonu's column and the books row. It is coming out to be 3. This is just a simple thing how we make use of the matrices. Why matrices are used? We have to understand here in class 10 how to form the matrices and the basic operations of matrices. Now, I just said to you, these horizontal things known as rows and columns. The first thing you should know how the matrices are characterized. Matrices are characterized by its order. And what is order of a matrix? The important first thing you are learning today is number of rows into number of columns. If a matrix is of format 3 into 2, the number of rows are 3 and the number of columns are 2. What does this mean? If I have to just write 3 into 2, this will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. So how many rows are here? 3. And how many columns are here? 1, 2. Vertical things, column. Horizontal thing, rows. Be very much clear. So, matrices to be identified like this. Now, I'm just writing. 1, 5, 7. Can you tell me the order of this matrix? Just try. See, one row is there. So, 1 into, count the columns. 1, 2, 3. 1 into 3. Another thing I'm writing. 5, 6, 9. Now tell, what's the order of that matrix? Rows, 1, 2, 3. Firstly, go for rows. So, 3 rows, 2, and the columns, just 1 column. So, 3 into 1 order. So, order of matrix is very easy to find. Now, how to find the elements of matrices? Suppose, an element of a matrix is characterized by Aij is equal to I plus j whole square. What is the meaning of this? The meaning of this, you know, the first, I'm just writing a matrix. This is 1, 1, first row, first column. Can you tell me this? 1, 2, this is 1, 3, this is 2, 1, this is 2, 2. This is 2, 3, like that, the things goes on. Suppose I have to form a 2 into 2 matrix, that is a square matrix, whose elements are being represented in this formula. So, it is a 2 into 2 matrix, so how many elements? 4 elements. What is it? A, 1, 1, A, 1, 2, A, 2, 1, A, 2, 2. So, I can find the elements very easily. A11 can be found out. Just see here, I'm doing A11 will be according to that formula. For I have taken 1. For j, I have taken 1. And we are getting A11. So, it will be 1 plus 1 whole square, which is coming out to be 4. So, 1, 1 element is 4. Now, I need to find A12. A12 is going to be I is 1 and J is 2. So this is 1 plus 2 whole square coming out to be 9. So here it is 9. A21, same way we can find. A22, we can find. So we can find the elements very easily if the formula is given. Once we know the designation of this element is A11, this A12, like this, A21, A22, this. Now we will see the equation of two matrices. That means two matrices are equal. This means that each and every corresponding element will be equal. Suppose two matrices are equal. It is x, y, 2, 5 is equal to 1, 4, 2, 5. What does this mean? That everything should be equal if equality sign is holding good. That means x should be 1. You can find easily x is equal to 1 and y is coming out to be 4. Same way some problems are like this. If it is like this and it is given as a plus b and this is given a minus 2b, like this, okay, and the two matrices are equal, what they are giving us? They're giving us a plus b will be equal to 1 and a minus 2b will be equal to 4. So we can solve them simultaneously and can get the values of A and B. So this is all about the equality of matrices. Now we will see the addition and subtraction operation of the matrices. If two matrices are added, it is 1, 2, 3, 4 like that, and another is 5, 3, 1, 6 like this. If we have to add two matrices, the corresponding elements are added in the case of addition and subtracted in the case of operation of subtraction. So the resultant of this will be, can you tell me, 1 will be added to 5, so 6, 2 will be added to 3, so 5, 3 will be added to 1, so 4. This 4 will be added to 6. That is coming out to be 10. So this is very basic addition of the matrices. Suppose I need to find a matrix. This is the resultant and this is given and the result is given and we need to find this matrix. This is A, this is B, this is C. And it is given that A plus B is equal to C. Find B. If I need to find B, what I will do? I have seen that matrix A is of order 2 into 2. C is also of 2 into 2. So the order of B will be 2 into 2. Because the like matrices can only be added. If a matrix is 2 into 2 order, add another 2 into 3 matrix and another is 2 into 2. We cannot add. We cannot add it. So for addition and subtraction of the matrices, their order should be same. Be careful. So this should be B we need to find. B should be of 2 into 2 order. Though 4 elements should be there. So I will write this as X, Y, U, V, like that. Just go for what they are saying in the question. You will get the value of the unknown thing very easily. So if you just write on addition, it will come out to be 1 plus X, this is 2 plus Y, this is 3 plus U, and this is 4 plus V is equal to the given thing here. See. Now A plus B is equal to C. Now equate the things. Basic equation. 1 plus X is 6. So x is coming out to be 5. 2 plus y is 5. 2 plus y is equal to 5. So y is equal to 3. Same way you can get the other variables. So wherever we need to find any matrix unknown, we take it in that fashion, x, y, u, v, if it is 2 into 2 order. If of different order, we take it accordingly. Now we should know what happening if a scalar is multiplied to a matrix. Suppose a matrix is 1, 2, 3, 4, a scalar 3. Suppose 3, k, 5, lambda, anything is multiplied to a matrix. That element is multiplied to each and every element of the matrix. So 3 will be multiplied to each and every. So the thing you are seeing here, when we have to multiply a scalar, that will be multiplied to all the elements. And the vice versa, if we have to take something common, we have to take common from all the elements. See here, I am multiplying here, it is coming out to be 3, 6, 9, 12. Okay, now if I want to take something common, I have to take common from each and every element. Suppose I am taking 3 common here, so it is coming out to be 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. So scalar multiplication is clear. Another thing you should know, identity matrix, that is unit matrix. Unit matrix is that matrix where diagonal elements are 1 and other elements are 0. That is unit matrix. This is known as I, symbolized as I. Sometimes they write I2. I2 means identity matrix of second order. If I need to write identity matrix of third order, no problem. Just 3 diagonal elements are 1 and rest elements are 0. Now, the most important thing we are going to do, the multiplication of matrices. See, two matrices can be multiplied only when it is in the fashion this. That means number of columns of first matrix should be equal to number of rows of the second matrix. Then only multiplication is possible. See, first criteria. Now you tell me, 3 into 2 can be multiplied to 3 into 2? Can it be multiplied to? No, because this 2 and 3 should be equal, and that is not equal here. Now if I say 1 into 3 is multiplied to 3 into 1, is it possible? Yes, you will say, because this is equal. So first thing in the multiplication of the matrices is to identify whether multiplication is possible or not possible. So the thing I say, I just write in this fashion, first matrix in M into N order, second in N into P. The result of the multiplication will be in the fashion M into P. That is very important thing you should know. Inner circle should match and outer thing extremes is giving us the resultant of the matrix. See, one example I am taking. Our matrix is 1, 2, 3, 4. What's the order? Can you tell me? 2 into 2. Another matrix I am taking 4, 5. What's the order? This is 2 into 1. Is the multiplication possible? Yes, because this 2 is matching. Can you tell me the result of the matrix? The result of the matrix is 2 into 1 order. So, be confident in whether the multiplication is possible and what will be the order of the resultant matrix. Now, how multiplication is carried out, that I am telling you. See, the first row is multiplied to first column. In local language we say it is multiplied in the formation of 7. So first row with the first column, how? 1 into 4 plus 2 into 5. Now The second row is multiplied to this column. So what will be that? 3 into 4 plus 4 into 5. So the result is, see here, 14, and this is 12, and 20, 32. See, the order of the resultant is 2 into 1. Suppose this is the question. Matrix A is given, matrix B is given, and we need to find matrix A. Firstly, we need to find the order of the matrix, then we will find what is the value of the matrix. So, we have to just write AX is equal to B. 2 is not going to change the order of the matrix. So, A's order is 2 into 2. B's order is 2 rows and 1 column. What should be the order of X? Tell me, if you just follow this thing, m into n is equal to n into p is equal to m into p. So, what you are finding? N is 2. So, order of x, this is x, okay, is 2 into, and what is p? P is 1. So, order of matrix x is 2 into 1. Be careful, if you just follow this basic thing and whatever is missing you find out from here, your things will be very easy. See here, m is 2, n is 2, and here we need n and p, so n is 2. And what is p? This is m into p, so 2 into 1, so p is 1. So we decided that order of the matrix is 2 into 1. Now you proceed. A is 2, A is 2, 3, 0, minus 2. X, we need to find 2 rows and 1 column. Can I take it as AB? You can take X, Y, anything, U, V, AB. 2 rows, 1 column. We need to find AB is equal to B is minus 8, 8. Just proceed the operation. If I multiply this 2 to here, it is coming out to be 4, 6, minus 4. Is it? 2 is multiplied to each and every element of the matrix. Don't think that 2 will be multiplied to this as well as this. No, multiplication, basic thing we know, it is to be multiplied to one thing, not both things. Not the plus case. Okay, be careful. So, on multiplication, this 7 formation like this, it is coming out to be 4a plus 6b. Is it? First row with first column. Okay, now the turn of the second row. Second row will be 0 into a is 0 minus 4b is equal to minus 8, 8. So, now equate the corresponding elements. 4a plus 6b is equal to minus 8 and minus 4b is equal to 8. So, b is coming out to be minus 2 here. You just put the value of b here. This is 4a minus 12 is equal to minus 8. So, 4a is equal to 4 and a is equal to 1. So, we got the value of a and b. So, matrix x will be 1. Minus 2. In this way, we can find the value of any unknown matrix by simply following the multiplication rule of the matrices. So, wherever you go for multiplication, be careful like this. And the multiplication process is first row, first column, first row, second column. Second row, first column, second row, second column, like that the process goes on. Follow it carefully. Hope your matrices are now becoming very, very easy for you. Matrices is just an arrangement of data. Suppose I am writing here A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. See, this is a matrix and it is characterized by its order, which is equal to number of rows
which is 3 here, and number of columns here, it is 3. So a matrix is characterized by the number of rows into number of columns. Can you identify what is the order of a matrix? I'm just writing here 1, 2, 3. Tell me how many rows? 1, 2, 3, and a column 1, 2, 3 into 1. In this way you can find the order of a matrix very easily. Two matrices can be added or subtracted only when their orders are same. So 2, 3, 4, 5, this can be subtracted or added to 1, 2, 3, 4. Why? Because order of this matrix is 2 into 2 and the order of this is also 2 into 2, this can be. What process we follow? We just individually add or subtract the element, corresponding element. So it is 1 plus 2 plus minus 1, 4 plus minus 3, 3 plus minus 2, 5 plus minus 4. According to what we want, addition or subtraction, we can go for it. Multiplication of matrices. Two matrices can be multiplied only when order of one matrix, suppose it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. What's the order of this matrix? 3 into 3. And order of another matrix, 1, 2, 3, like this. What's the order of this matrix? 3 into 1. The inner circle should match. So, in technical language, we say if the order of the matrix is P into Q, first matrix, the second matrix should be Q into R format, like that. This should match. Then only the multiplication is possible and the resultant matrix is of P into R order. How we follow the multiplication process? See here, a 7 formation is here, a technique. You multiply the first row with the first column, which is going to be the first element of the resultant matrix. So how we are doing? 1 into 1 plus 2 into 2 plus 3 into 3. How? 1 with this 1, 2 with this 2, 3 with this 3. This is first row with first column. No more columns are there. So, nothing to write in the second element of first row. Now, second row is coming into play. This is with this. It will be 4 into 1 plus 5 into 2 plus 6 into 3, like this. And the third element we can find of the resultant matrix as 7 into 1. Plus 8 into 2 plus 9 into 3. So this is multiplication of the matrices. Now we will see what is the transpose of a matrix. If a matrix is in the form 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this, you want to write 7, 8, 9, no problem. The transpose of this matrix will be transpose, ETV, symbolize it. The rows are made column and columns are made rows. So first row, I am making first column. Second row, I am making second column, and third row, the third column. This is the transpose of a matrix. Now, two types of matrices I am discussing, symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. Symmetric matrix is that matrix in which elements along its principal diagonal are equal. You know, what's the definition of this element? This is A11. A11 stands for first row, first column. This will be A12. First row, second column, A13. Like that. Here it will be A21, A22 here, A23. This is A31, A32, A33 here, A22 here. So these two elements are equal. These two, these two. So A12 will be equal to A21. A13 will be equal to A31. Like this, A23 is equal to A32. This is symmetric matrix. Symmetric matrix. Skew symmetric matrix is that matrix. Skew symmetric is that matrix in which these elements are negative of each other. So what we write, A12 is equal to negative of A21. A13 is negative of A31. So symmetric and skew symmetric matrices, clear to you. Now see, if you find A plus AT, that means if a matrix is added to its transpose, it is always symmetric matrix. Suppose I am taking one example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What is, it should be a square matrix, 7, 8, 9. Its transpose is 1, 4, 7, 2, 5, 8, 3, 6, 9. For adding, it is going to give you 2, 6, 10, 6, 10, 14, 10, 14, and 18. See here, this is the main diagonal. This is equal to this, this is equal to this. So always A plus 80 is symmetric. Same way, A minus 80 is skew symmetric. Skew symmetric. Yes? Now, just dealing with identity matrix. Identity matrix is that matrix whose diagonal elements are 1, 1, 1 and rest elements are 0. This is designated as I3. Why? This is identity matrix of third order. This is identity matrix. What is A inverse? A inverse is, it should be 1 by A in general algebra, but in matrix language, 1 is standing for I, so I by A. So, results you are getting, A into A inverse is I. Okay? Another method, I am telling you how to find A inverse. For finding that, we need adjoint of a matrix. See, what is adjoint of a matrix? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. If this is a matrix, we have to find adjoint of this. You just remember the definition of adjoint matrix. I just write it, each element being replaced by its cofactor and then transposed. Okay, what I will be doing here for finding adjoint A, 1 will be replaced by its cofactor. What is cofactor of 1? See, for finding cofactor, the corresponding column and row is getting cancelled. We are left with 4 elements here. We multiply it crisscross, 5 into 9 is 45 minus 8 into 6, 48. So it is coming out to be minus 3. Same way, we will find that of 2, cofactor of 2, that will be, you just cancel this and this, you are left with 4 elements. This is 4 into 9, 36, minus 7 into 6, 42. That is minus 6. But see, the sign of this place is negative, so you have to put negative in front of that. Same way, you find the cofactor of each and every element here, 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 and then transpose the complete thing. While finding the cofactors, be careful what sign has to be prefixed here. See, this sign is positive, and I am giving you a rule that every neighbor got opposite sign of its neighbor. So it is positive, this will be negative, so this will be positive, this has to be negative, this has to be positive, this has to be negative. This way you just prefix the sign and write the value. You will get adjoint A easily. Now finding A inverse. A inverse is adjoint A by determinant A. Adjoint A, you got the value. Determinant A, which will be seen in determinant chapter, you will just get the value of that and we will find A inverse. Another thing, using matrix method to solve three equations. Suppose three equations are like that. Okay, so solving this, we write Ax is equal to B. So X is A inverse into B. X is basically the variables x, y, z. A inverse is the inverse of the coefficients of x, y, z, that is 1, 1, 1, 2, minus 3, 4, 2, minus 4, 3, its inverse. And B is the RHS thing, 4, 5, 8. You get this. Furthermore, if we just simplify this, for A inverse, what we can write? Adjoint A by determinant A into B. Now, very important thing I am going to tell you about the consistency and non-consistency of the solution of the three equations. If you see, this is the solution, so we have to concentrate here. If determinant A is not zero, equations got solution. Got solution is termed as consistent. That means equations are consistent. It got a solution. And what type of solution? It is unique solution. Unique means x got single value, y got single value, and z got single value. So by just seeing this, we can predict what the solution can be. Second case, if determinant A is 0, but adjoint A into B not 0, then no solution. No solution means inconsistent. Third case, this is important case, if determinant A 0 and adjoint A into B is also 0, then there will be two cases. We will solve two equations simultaneously and get values of x and y. X and y in terms of z. In terms of, suppose I am saying k, which is equal to z. Take z is equal to k and get the values of a and b, x and y, in terms of z. Put these two values in third equation. If it satisfies third equation, then it got infinite many solution. What is the meaning of infinite many solution? That x got so many values, y got so many values, z got so many values. Why? Because z is k can be anything. X is in the terms of k, 2k minus 3 suppose. Y is 5k minus 6 suppose. I got the values of x and y in terms of k by solving the two equations. K can be anything. So infinite many solution. If does not satisfy, then no solution. That means again the equations are inconsistent.
We will find A inverse with the help of elementary method. Suppose I am taking one question, 3, 10, 2, 7, like this. Okay. What basic thing I have to follow is A is equal to I into A. Because I is multiplied to anything will give you the same thing. And finding A inverse, I have to write I by A. This thing we will use throughout in our elementary method to find A inverse. See what we are doing here. If I am writing A is equal to I into A, it is coming out to be A is 310, 27, I we know 1001 into A. Firstly, I have to bring here 1. This can be done if at R1 I write R1 minus R2. So it will give you 1, 3, 2, 7. R2 is remaining same. Same operation we have to do here. So on doing R1 minus R2, it is 1 minus 1, 0, 1, A. Okay. Now I have to bring a 0 here. That can be brought if I go for in R2. R2 minus 2 into R1, the R2 will become 0, 1, this is remaining 1, 3, and same way we have to make changes R2 here. This is 0 minus 2 into minus 2, and this is 1 minus
minus 2, that is 3, and it is remaining same, 1, minus 1, 8, okay. So almost we got, but this 3 has to be made 0. This can easily be done if I write at R1 minus R2, 2 into R2, 3 into R2, sorry, because I have to make it 0. R1 minus 3R2. So it is coming out to be 1, 0, 0, 1. Correspondingly, I have to make the change here. It is coming out to be R1 minus, that is 1 minus 3 into minus 2, minus 6. That is coming out to be 7. And here, minus 1 minus 9. That is minus 8. And it is remaining same. A. Now see, this is I. If I write this as I and bring this A here, I am left with this thing, 7 minus 8 minus 2, 3 like this. And what is this? We know by basic definition, this is A inverse. So automatically we got A inverse. This is the way we find A inverse. One more example I am taking. 2, 1, 1, 1, like this. Okay, I have to find A inverse here. Same method I will follow. A is equal to I into A. So this is 2, 1, 1, 1 is equal to 1, 0, 0, 1, A. Okay. So I have to make here 1. What I will do at R1, I will go for R1 minus R2 simply. So it will be 1, this is 0, and this is 1, 1. Same way we have to make the change at R1 here. This is 1, this is minus 1, 0, 1, A. Okay. So almost the thing is done. I have to make 1, 0 here. This can be easily made by operating as R2 minus R1. What will be the result? At R2, it will be 0, 1, it is 1, 0. Change will take place at R2. This is R2 minus R1, so minus 1. And R2, 1, minus minus, this is 2, 1, minus 1, remaining same, A. And again, we know that this is I. And I by A is going to give us A inverse. So this is I. I'm bringing this A here. It is A inverse. And A inverse we are getting automatically. So this is A inverse. Now I will find A inverse in a matrix which is 3 into 3 order. Suppose it is 2, 0, 1, 5, 1, 0. If you write it minus 1 and third row 0, 1, 3. Okay. You just follow the basic principle, that is A is equal to I into A. So this A is here 2, 0, minus 1, 5, 1, 0, 0, 1, 3 is equal to I. I is here 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay? So, what thing you have to do? First thing I told you, make this thing as 1. How can you make this thing as 1? You can make this thing as 1 if you just take 2 common from R1. That means if you R1 is divided by 1 by 2, it is going to give you 1, 0, minus 1 by 2. All the things are remaining same. 0, 1, 3. See? And here also if you are dividing by 2, it is 1 by 2, 0, 0. And the things are remaining same. 0, 0, 1. Like this. Okay? A. So this operation we have gone for. Now I have to make 2 zeros here. Where? Here and here. Luckily here it is. So if at R2 I go for R2 minus 5 into R1. So the change will take place at R2 and R2 will become here 0. If you multiply this R2 minus this, this is becoming 1. And this is 0 minus 5 by 2 is 5 by 2. All the things remaining same. 1, 0, minus 1 by 2. Okay, same way you take changes at R2. So R2 minus 5 into that is minus 5 by 2. Here it is remaining 1 and here it is remaining 0. 0, 0, 1, half, 0, 0. You have to do little bit carefully, because if you make any mistake, plus minus mistake, you will not get the correct answer. Okay, now I got two zeros here, one is here, one is here, zero is luckily here. I have to make zero here and one here. Now I make this thing as zero. How can I make this? See, if at R3, firstly this has to be one, this is one. If I'm making this zero, our work will be easier. See, if at R3, I go for R3 minus R2, R3 will be 0, 0, and this is 1 by 2, and the things are remaining same, 1, 0, 1, 5 by 2, 1, 0, minus 1 by 2, okay? Same way, R3 minus R2 is going to give you here 5 by 2, R3 minus R2, this is minus 1, this is 1, this is minus 5 by 2, 1, 0, 1 by 2, 0, 0, like this into A. Now the things are becoming simpler. I have to make now 0 here. This can be easily made, you see, because I have to attain the structure 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, like this. Here at R1, if I go for R1 plus R3, at R1, if I go for R1 plus R3, it is coming out to be 1, 0, no change here, and it is becoming 0. R2 is remaining same, 0, 1, 5 by 2, 0, 0, 1 by 2. Okay, and here I go for at R1 plus R3. Okay, so this is coming out to be 3, this is coming out to be minus 1, and this is coming out to be 1, this is minus 5 by 2, 1, 0, 5 by 2, minus 1, 1, into A. See, now things are becoming simpler. 1, 0, 0 is attained here, 0, 1, now I have to make here 0. Firstly, go for zeros, 1 will automatically come. Make 1 here and then hunt for 0, 0, 0, 0, okay? So, if I go for here, making zeros, so at R2, I have to go for operation at R2 minus 5 into R3. So, R2 will become 0, 1, 5 by 2 minus 5 by 2, 0. This is remaining same, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. 1 by 2. What operation I have gone for at R2? R2 minus 5 into R3. So R1 is remaining same, R3 is remaining same, only change will take place at R2. So if I multiply this 5, this will be 15 by 2, minus 5 by 2, minus 15 by 2, that is minus 20 by 2, that is coming out to be minus 10. If I multiply minus 1 with 5, that will be minus 5. And subtract it from R2 1, this is coming out to be 6, and here if I multiply 1 with 5, this is coming out to be 5. 0 minus 5 is minus 5. Okay, now almost the thing is done. I have to make it 1. So if I multiply R3 by 2, 2 into R3 is giving us 0, 0, 1. It is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, again, and here, what operation I have done here, I have to do that thing here, R3, 2, to be multiplied, so it is becoming 5, this is minus 2, this is 2, this is minus 10, 6, minus 5, this is 3, minus 1, 1, A, this is I. So we got, when this is I, and if I bring that A to this side, this is I by A, which is actually A inverse, and we got it. This is 3, minus 1, minus 5, minus 10, 6, minus 5, 3, minus 1, 1, it was 1, okay, minus 10, 6, minus 5, 5, minus 2, 2, this is A inverse, little bit long process, but if you systematically follow it, you will get A inverse.